Talk about goals. Well, I don't know how you guys feel, but at the end of the day, as a collective group, we're trying to win a Vanier Cup. It's all there. When you go through the roster, you go, yep, 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 checking boxes. Talent's here to win. Simple as that. Simple. The challenge is, how do we get there?
There wasn't a lot of buzz around sports, period, at Carleton. We didn't go to the games. The stands were empty.
The athletics program was among the worst in the country. When I was there, there were rumors that they were going to get rid of the football team.
I don't know all the politics involved. All I know is that there was a head of athletics here who thought that football, I guess, was too expensive. Plus, the team wasn't winning very much in the 90s.
There's a reason why they dumped that program. And some of it was money, some of it was politics, but I think a lot of it had to do with just the succession of losses that that team suffered.
I do remember a buddy calling me or something and saying they killed the Ravens football program, and it almost felt inevitable because the program had been so weak.
For whatever reason, I don't know why I had it in my head, but I always said I want to start a program. St. Mary's and I went in different directions, and I got a call about 2 days after that for it come up for an interview. And you know, this opportunity to come work at Carleton and build something from the ground up, you could never pass it up.
The opportunity to come in from a fresh start and like rebuild a program, that was something that I was like, let's do this. It was just kind of an exciting thing to be a part of.
There was nothing here. There was nothing to show. There was a rundown old field. The whole idea of starting it off, I don't know what it was. It just stuck deep inside me, and I was like, this is building for something.
You had to be okay with getting your ass kicked the first year. Like, you had to be okay with that, come to terms with that, and then understand that it was a process from there.
Getting your ass kicked together, knowing that you're going somewhere, is like, I think it's one of the most important things that we have here.
That growth from year one to year four for Carleton has been amazing. To see them improve each and every year is impressive, but the hardest step is always the last step. And for them, I think that's this season.
Okay, gentlemen. Now it's real. This is the opportunity that we get to come together as a collective group and wear our name proudly on our jerseys.
I think we were just trying to go in and show the other way, okay, we're here.
Hastings again out of the pistol. Time to throw, he's going down the field, and he's got a man! And down the sidelines, it's a touchdown! First and 10 for Mills, he'll operate out of the pistol, has time, now steps up into a crowd, and he's going to be pulled down for a sack. He has one here this evening. Looks to the right side, man is wide open, Max Cameron, touchdown, Marauder. Again, he'll step back and pass. Shuffle step, he's going down the field, and it's going to be caught! A touchdown! Number 83, it looked like Dan.
We were confident a bunch wouldn't do it, and coming out of it, I think it humbled us a little bit in a good way, so.
We understood after that game that, like, just because we say we want to win a Vanier, and we say that we prepare to win a Vanier, that doesn't mean that we're going to go and beat a team that's won Vanier, just because we feel like it's our time.
We had to not look at Western as Western. We had to look at Western as another opponent. because the minute we looked at Western as, oh, it's Western, you know, they've won this many Yates Cups, they've won this many Vaniers, they're a powerhouse, it really kind of kicks you in the gut and you start to wonder if you even believe that you can be on the field.
I think coming into this one, it's pretty fair to say that the Western Mustangs will be favored in this game, and they will be favored heavily.
Bone works the pass, has a nice clean pocket, nothing open downfield. Now he's flushed out, just has to dump it to the sideline. Nice attempt at the catch, but it is incomplete.
I knew like we needed something exciting. We needed to start off the game with energy.
In the pocket, if Carlton wants to have sustained success tonight.
When I got that return, broke a few tackles, saw in, I knew I had to hit it.
Here's the return by Adelike. Held up, but now he busts it up the sideline, and Funde Adelike running free. Adelike, one man to beat, just the punter. Adelike down the sideline. See you in the end zone. Touchdown, Carlton Ravens. There is no flag. And it's Rowe cutting it into the secondary, and Jade Rowe is off and running inside the 40. It's a foot race. He's fighting off a tackler, and he will go in. See you in the end zone. Carlton Ravens touchdown. 74 yards. And off it's Rowe leaping over. See you in the end zone. Touchdown, Carlton Ravens.
We're kind of looking at each other in the locker room at halftime, like, okay, we knew we could beat them, but we didn't expect this. But the same thing at halftime, it was like, okay, keep the foot on the pedal because they're going to come out in the second half and fight.
Seven across the line and then an up back and three in the backfield. Hand off Cedric Joseph, and he goes in from a yard out.
So when they were coming back, it was a little, I was nervous as hell.
You know, I'm kind of going up the sidelines and be like, come on, fellas, like, this is a football game. We know what we're doing.
And you go to Taylor, who else? He bounces off the tackle and leans out and has the touchdown.
It was tough emotionally on the sidelines. I brought the guys in going in the fourth quarter and was like, come on, man, like, don't let this slip away. This is our game to win.
Yeah, offsides, that's a bit of a killer. As Mills loads it up down the right side, out to the flat, and a beautiful catch by Bahar on that sideline. Mills pump fake, man wide open, caught at the pylon, touchdown, see you in the end zone, touchdown Carlton Ravens.
We had 2 minutes left and we had a nice drive to tie it up, but in my mind it was like, we're not losing this game.
There's Rowe kicking it to the outside, following his blockers. Jade Rowe breaks this one down inside the 20, rolled out of bounds at the 16. Mills, corner route, has a man behind coverage. Touchdowns! Carlton goes on top with 2:45 to play.
Stevenson Bone back out. He's going to try and lead Western the length of the field.
Now it's Taylor back in the game, and he's got a first down carry. Bone fakes, loads it up, completed, and they survive again. They bring McMaster in motion. Bone looks right side, has the completion, but the receiver stumbles and falls short of the first down. And now they just need one more stop. Third and six at the 7. It's handoff. Joseph is ahead. He's going to be close. I don't know. It doesn't look like it.
He might be short. They're walking off the field, though.
The Ravens have done it. They've done it! The Carlton Ravens are going to upset the Western Mustangs.
A historic program-defining victory is what this is going to be for the Carlton Ravens.
It has come to fruition. The Carlton Ravens take down the Western Mustangs.
The guys really held it in. Like, that's one of my proudest moments for sure out of all these guys, that they buckled down and batten down the hatches when they started coming back at us. It was pretty cool.
You know, when we walked off the field after beating Western, I felt like, okay, we're back. You know, all those things I was concerned about the week before kind of went away, and now I'm like, okay, let's get our momentum going. Let's get some more confidence.
Now it's karaoke, but the key thing is we can't hear the music, so we're gonna try to guess, okay?
Here we go.
So let me tell you now. When I had you to myself, I didn't want you around. Those pretty faces always made me stand out in the crowd. But someone picked you from the bunch. One glance is all it took. Now it's way too much for me. Take a second look. Here we go!
I looked at the Laurier game and my initial reaction was if we win that game, we're gonna finish first in the conference. To me, this game against Laurier was the game, and the outcome of this was gonna decide our fate of where we were gonna be.
Mills drops back, throws it, floats it to the deep end zone, and it is caught in the near corner of the end zone. Yes, sir. Neville, handoff to Gilton, and he's going to motor up the left side. He's going to go to 30, the 20, the 10.
It was just a straight slugfest. It kind of reminded me more of a playoff game than anything. I mean, the rain was coming down. It was just back and forth.
When we saw it was like downpouring for a bit and stopping, downpouring for a bit, we were like, they're going to run this ball.
And they are up and over and in.
When it's torrentially downpouring, when it's that horrid, and they're like, okay, we're down, and there's not a lot of time left on the clock, like, everyone gets a little more nervous, I think.
One creeps up to the line for Laurier. Neville, hand off to Gilton, and up the middle, he's gonna find a hole, he's gonna go 50. Midfield, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, and finally brought down. Definitely a step backwards for the Ravens today against a Laurier team that I think is gonna surprise quite a few people in the league this season.
At some point, you gotta decide what you wanna be. Right now, I don't know what you want to be. I can just tell you what you are. And you're 2-2. I'm telling you what you need to do. You need to figure out if that's what you want to do.
Well, the good thing was that, you know, Panda was around the corner. Really, Panda's the biggest game of the year. It's the biggest rivalry in the country. It's a game that's been going for 50 plus years. It's the game that Carleton and Ottawa U get a chance to have bragging rights in the city of Ottawa.
It's as big as any playoff game you could ever play. You'll play before more spectators in a bigger, big game environment than you'll ever play.
60 minutes of just good old-fashioned hate. Pull yourself out of the game for half a second and be like, this is dope. This is nothing short of just dope.
5 minutes gone by in the 2016 Panda Bowl. Wendell is picked off. Jay Dearborn with his fourth interception of the season. They gotten to the end zone 14 times. Make it 15. Touchdown, Nate Behar. First down and 10. Wendell on the option. Gives it up. Touchdown, Ottawa.
It looked like it was going to be one of those games again, those high-scoring games, but then we just got to the game plan.
Mills to Behar. It's always Christmas with Nate Behar. Ravens fans into it.
J-Row sometimes.
A chance for the lead on first and goal. J-Row. No signal yet. Touchdown, Carlton. That'll do it after two quarters of play. And it's 21-13 Carlton at the break.
Come on, man. Woo! We win this game right now, right out of the gate. Hey, believe in each other. Believe in your teammates.
Believe in it, man.
Let's do this.
You got a fake? Fake indeed. There go the Ravens. There goes Wilson Birch to the 15-yard line. Mills. Touchdown, Ravens. Nate Behar, no doubt about it. And so now Lewis Ward, who is 14 of 14 on the season, will attempt this one from 37.
When you get your chance to get a missed field goal return, it's just, you gotta put it all in.
Wide left.
Caught it, went to the right, saw nothing was there, and then came back, and there was an opening in the middle. I hit it, and it was running free.
It was exciting to see how excited everyone else was about us having to play Ottawa U again, like at home.
So they wanted to stand on our crest and kind of and wave their flag. We're in the tunnel. I remember I was right at the front of the tunnel. I'm sitting there watching. I'm like, uh-oh, this is gonna be fun.
We were excited. We were on our home field. We go to the middle of our field because that's what home teams do. We just defend what's ours.
And we've never seen anything like this in an OUA playoff game.
You could tell right away. It was like, we came to the sideline, we're all pissed off, and then it was kind of like, that's fake.
The receiver's to the bottom of the screen. Wilson Birch versus the three receiver in the slot. Look out for him, as it's Jesse Mills looking left side, looking to the end zone for Wilson Birch, and see you in the end zone. That's a touchdown for the Carlton Ravens. Mills. Throw off the left side, met in the backfield, but has a lane, and see you in the end zone. Jade Rowe punches it in with 6:16 to go. Jesse Mills is going to keep it on the play action. Jesse Mills, beautiful fake on the bootleg. Rattles Jackson Bennett, and it's a first down at the 30. Play PPR. Get hung on that one pass, and it's Christian Battistelli. And that opens up Christian Battistelli.
See you in the end zone. Touchdown, Carlton Ravens, a 56-yard run. As the Ravens close it out, 45-9. They'll be at either Laurier or Western next week.
We knew that we were going to have a tough game in the semis.
Jesse Mills is about to get the first snap of the game. Take a two-step drop and arcs it up high, right into the hands of Ferguson. An interception to start the game for the Western Mustangs.
Go. All right, let's go.
Fake handoff once again. Throws to the right slot. Jumps into the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs. They hand it off to Cedric Joseph. Untouched off the left side.
The guys are thinking like, oh, this is just going to be like what it's always like when you're at TD Waterhouse, sitting on this purple sideline with these silver benches, this white table, and our cows right here, and they're scoring points, and we're sitting here.
Three-step drop and a bullet.
We showed flashes of, hey, we're coming back, we're coming back. But when you needed to make a play, we just didn't make the play.
Hands it off to Cedric Joseph, and he easily gets in.
It's just kind of like heartbreaking that like halfway through the game you could tell that like this was a team that was ready to go to Yates and we were a team that was not, I guess.
It's a weird feeling fighting back tears and then having to go play a sport like football. You're looking at guys you know are never going to play another down of football and you're seeing that set in.
It was kind of just me kind of, I guess, while playing and on the sideline, I was kind of just going through my head where I came from playing football and how much I like enjoyed it when I was just throwing a ball in the park and how much I still enjoyed it.
Well, it's going to be a tough loss for Carlton Ravens. They've really done a great job building their program up.
51-24, the Western Mustangs win on home field.
The thing that makes you realize that it's worth it is like game's over, you shake hands, and then like someone comes and grabs you and just brings you in for a hug. It's like, whoever the hell it is that comes and embraces you, you're kind of like, yeah, we did that shit together. We took that L together, but hey, we won some games together, and we did all this shit together, so it's worth it.
I love you, man. Couldn't have done that without you. I was killing you.
Bond you form when you're getting your ass whooped is stronger than any bond you can ever create.
So we went through a lot together and I think that definitely like helped mold us together into like the brotherhood that we are really. There's no doubt that I could not see one of these guys for 15 years and then like see them like one day down the street and I don't think anything would ever change.
The diversity of what we've been through, the spectrum of what we've been through, for the highs and the lows, I don't know if that can be matched by anybody. And the fact that we all know what kind of a person we came here with, all the fourth year guys, all the guys that came here, all the originals, it's like no regular dude could have showed up when there was no locker room, when the coach didn't even have offices and signed the name on the dotted line. You're Raven for life, as corny as it is. And we're gonna have each other forever, that's for sure.